Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn, and in this tutorial we'll look at how we can take our rough drawing or rough animation through to the cleanup stage using the pencil tool, and later on we'll show you how to add color. Following on from the brush tool, we have our rough drawing or our rough animation. My character, Audrey, is made up of two layers, one which is the drawing of Audrey and the other of the chair. We're going to make a new drawing and call it cleanup. We'll select the pencil tool, which is probably the most dynamic of all the tools. This is the one we would choose for any cleanup and making sure that the character is on model. We can go to the tool properties and make sure we have the right size. There's also options on the presets, so you can have a look at what you'd like to use. We need to put the light table on over here, and this enables a transparent layer to be visible so we can see through to the other layers without it being distracting. We also have the option to change the opacity, so we can open up the light table settings. Choose the light table opacity. As you move the scale up and down, it has varying opacity strengths. Now let's go in with the pencil tool and start tracing off and tying down our character. What I would say is, at this stage, you don't have to worry too much about accuracy in your line, but sketch quite freely. I'm not going to worry too much about it being perfect because we're going to go to the contour editor. The contour editor allows you to smooth out the line and to really shape and, in a way, keep drawing into what you have with the pencil tool. The trick is to be confident and just ping the line so that what you're trying to achieve is the least amount of the little points that you see, the little orange dots. When you select the contour editor, you can also delete points by selecting on the orange points and hitting delete. If you want to add points, hold down Command and click on the line to make a point. You can also select on the point and the Bezier handle comes up. The Bezier handle can be used to manipulate the line. Control just one handle at a time by holding down Option. For any differences in the line thickness, we can also choose a tool called the pencil editor. The pencil editor allows you to make sure that all your line thickness is consistent, if that's what you want. And you can just select on the little red dots and delete them. The pencil editor can also be used to taper your lines. You can do that by holding down Command and then clicking on the line. This gives you an extra point so you can manipulate the line using the Bezier handles to create more of a tapered ending. You can also delete any points that aren't needed. Once we've cleaned up our rough animation or our drawing and made sure everything is on model, select K to bring up the stroke and C where we may have gaps. And we need to make sure all the gaps are closed to be able to add color later. So where we see the yellow dots is where it indicates that there's a gap. Put on the snap to contour and drag and connect to the stroke. One last thing is that you can select your drawing by using the select tool. Make sure that you've got your drawing on the line art layer. And now you can try different textures, such as the chalk, for instance, and also change up the size so that it's consistent. And that's it for the pencil tool. See you next time.